next problem. The volume tangency rho v is equal to k by r, r naught equal to 0, exists in a sphere of radius equal to a. Find vector e for r greater than a. Use Gauss law. Solution. We have got a sphere of radius equal to a meters. Charges are uniformly distributed in the sphere with a density rho v coulombs per meter cube. We have to find electric field density for r greater than a. Therefore, Gaussian surface must be drawn outside the sphere. And radius of the Gaussian surface is r. R is greater than a. This is Gaussian surface. This is Gaussian surface. This is point P. If you keep one coulomb charge at point P, this positive cloud will repel it. Positive spherical cloud will repel it. This is vector D equal to what? Dr into Er cap. These are the flux lines coming out of the Gaussian surface. Step 1. According to Gauss law, what is psi? Psi is equal to Q enclosed is equal to volume integral rho v dv. Volume, in this volume only charges are present. Therefore, when you take the limit for r, it should be from 0 to a. Please keep it in mind. So, triple integral, one for r running from 0 to a, one for theta running from 0 to pi, one for phi running from 0 to 2 pi. What is rho v? Rho v is not a constant. It is a function of r, k by r. What is dv? R square sine theta dr d theta d phi. So this becomes now k, you pull it out. If you integrate d phi, you get phi. Put limits 0 to 2 pi. If you integrate sine theta, you get minus cos theta 0 to pi. If you integrate r square by r, r remains. If you integrate r, you get r square by 2 between 0 and a. So this becomes now k into 2 pi r square by r. One r gets cancelled. R if integrate, you get r square by 2 into 2 into a square by 2. So this 2 gets cancelled. You get 2 pi k a square. So many coulombs. 2 pi. So psi is equal to what? 2 pi k a square. Second step, to find vector D at point P. We know that psi is equal to closed surface integral vector D dot ds. This implies psi is equal to closed surface integral. What is vector D? Dr into Er cap dot. What is vector ds? Here, S refers to the area of, surface area of the Gaussian sphere. Ds is, vector ds is what? Dsr into Er cap. We are finding the area of the dotted sphere. Therefore, look at the limits for r. So, integration, r is equal to 0 to r, not a. Right? Theta varying from 0 to pi. Phi varying from 0 to 2 pi. Dr into dsr is what? Dsr is dl2 into dl3. dl2 into dl3 is dsr. What is dl2? R into d theta. What is dl3? R into sine theta into d phi. So you get r square sine theta d theta d phi. Sorry, I made a small mistake. This is a surface integral, double integral. Therefore, the integration with respect to r is removed. What is dsr? Dsr is what? Dsr is r square sine theta d phi. Surface integral is a double integral. So I accidentally wrote it as a triple integral. Please remove the triple integral. Integrate now. Dr is a constant. Sine theta, if you integrate, you get minus cos theta. Limits from 0 to pi. correct? What is the constant in this integral? Dr into r square. Sin theta if integrate you get minus cos theta d phi, if integrate you get phi, limits 0 to 2 pi. So this is dr into r square into 2 into 2 pi. So this is nothing but dr into 4 pi r square. This implies, what is dr equals? This is psi, okay. So what is dr? Psi divided by 4 pi r square. What is psi? Psi is what? 2 pi k into a square divided by 4 pi r square. So it is nothing but k into a square divided by 2 r square. So many coulombs per meter square. Hence, vector d is equal to dr into ar cap. What is dr? Dr is k into a square divided by 2 r square into ar cap. Unit is coulombs per meter square. Third step, to find electric field intensity at point P. Once you know vector D, vector E calculation is very simple. We know that vector D is equal to epsilon into vector E. This implies vector E is equal to vector D divided by epsilon equals K into A square divided by 2 epsilon R square into AR cap. So many volts per meter. This is the end of the problem.